staying, you're going to go with?
This could be the first major hurricane to hit Florida in about 4 years, since about 2018. So this is going to be a little bit different.
And with the eye projected to go directly over Tampa, it will be the first time in 100 years that the city has been in a hurricane's path.
Just check them off.
300 people from across the U.S. have already been deployed by the Red Cross to help individuals in Florida. Of these people, a handful is from the DMV area.
They've received an extensive amount of training and raised a hand about their availability to deploy.
Dale Kuntz is the regional CEO of the DC area Red Cross. He is among these volunteers helping to provide shelter, food, and emotional support to Floridians who will be affected by this storm.
All of us here at the Red Cross kind of have a passion for what we do. So if we have to stay awake half the night, that's what we do.
The National Hurricane Center confirmed this morning that Ian has emerged as a major Category 3 hurricane. You can see it here on this radar. And with it come these warnings. Tropical storm conditions by tonight. Hurricane winds by tomorrow morning, timed when people will be asleep, making this even more of a threat. The American Red Cross will continue to stay on the ground in Florida for as long as they are needed while they are working overtime here at home.
And we also support our staff who's deployed down in Florida. So we're kind of working double time to make sure they have what they need, but that we're continue to be here functioning as normal for folks right here in the DMV who need us.
For CNS TV News, I'm Haley Kirby.